Ender is he's one of the few bright, bright children on Earth who have been brought up playing these games, pretty much bred for this one person, which is to protect Earth from this invasion, which they are convinced is coming. And Ender ends up getting promoted to Battle School, where he goes up there. It's where he meets Petra, Haley's character, and all of these other people, which end up becoming huge parts of his life, even though he doesn't know it. It all gets very exciting. I don't want to give away too much, but it's amazing, yeah.
Obviously, the film's based on a very beloved book. What do you think fans can expect from the adaptation? How well do you think the magic of the book transfers to screen?
I think whenever a book is transferred to cinema, there is always the chance that it can lose a lot of its integrity and what makes it such an amazing book. But I think for Ender's Game, we've done an amazing job. Gavin, Bob, Gigi, all of us have really made it the book, but just in a different medium. I think everything, every single moment which means something, and every single idea and underlying layer which is really important in the book, we've kept intact, and I think we've really have done it justice.
I think, of course, the action sequences seem to be unlike perhaps anything we've seen in a sci-fi film before. Can you tell us a little bit about them?
It is, and when I first read the script, I had no idea how they were going to pull any of that off. And when I read the book, I was like, wait, how are they going to do this? And I guess we did, and it's phenomenal. The Garrett, the stunt coordinator, and the special effects team, they've done an incredible job of creating, well, especially the battle room, creating this room where the most incredible scenes can be created.
Of course, you've had the pleasure of working with Sir Ben before, but this time Harrison Ford. I mean, how does that feel? You must have been quite nervous, I'd imagine, first day on set with him.
I was, to say the least. I think anyone would be. But once you get to know him, you do realise that he's such an incredible... Not only is he an amazing actor, but he's an amazing person. And I think, especially for us younger cast, he really did bring the best out of us as actors.
Harrison told us that obviously your characters have quite a complex relationship. It's really right at the heart of the film. Can you talk a little bit about that and working on it with him?
Yeah, Ender and Garth's relationship is really key, and you see a lot of it from the very start of the film to the end. The development is monumental. The end of the film, and you see how Ender, originally he was pretty intimidated. Garth was pretty high up above him, and by the end of the film, Ender's standing up to him. He's getting his voice out, and I think that change is you can see it, and I think it's really quite something.
It's an ambitious project. You need a great director for that. What made Gavin the right man for the job?
Gavin, I haven't worked with anyone like Gavin before. The amount of energy and heart and the amount of energy he put into it, and then because he wrote the screenplay, he knew it back to front, and it was contagious. Like when he was shouting, saying, get everyone to do this, because we didn't have anything to react to, we just had this green screen, all we had was Gavin shouting his heart out, not angrily, but to get us into the moment where we were here, and he was the one who was convincing us that we were seeing these spaceships. It was amazing.
It's been amazing to talk to you. Do you have a message for fans about Ender's Game before you leave us?
Go and see it on October 25th and enjoy it. I'm sure you will.